Abandoning his load of luggage, he mounted the cloud somersault and leapt clear of the building through a window. The monster spirit led a thorough search for the Tang monk at the front and back of the monastery, but they failed to turn up anyone. When he saw that it was almost light, he took his club and led his troops to give chase. Beneath the mountain slope, still shrouded by cloud and fog, were the 28 constellations, the guardian of five quarters, and the other deities. "Where do you think you're going?" shouted the monster king. "Here I am, brothers," cried Horn the wood dragon. "The fiendish creature's here." Whereupon Gullet the gold dragon, Woman the earth bat, Chamber the sun hare, Heart the moon fox, Tail the fire tiger, Winnower the water leopard, Dipper the wood unicorn, Ox the gold bull, Base the earth badger, Barons the sun rat, Roof the moon swallow, House the fire hog, Wall the water porcupine, Straddler the wood wolf, Harvester the gold hound, Stomach the earth hog, Mane the sun rooster, Net the moon crow, Beak the fire monkey, Triaster the water ape, Well the wood hound, Ghost the gold ram, Willow the earth antelope, Star the sun horse, Spread the moon deer, Wing the fire serpent, and Axle tree the water earthworm led the golden-headed guardian, the silver-headed guardian, the six gods of light and darkness, the guardians of monasteries, eight rules, and Sha monk to meet their pursuers. Abandoning the Tripitaka Tang and forsaking the white dragon horse, they rushed into battle, each with weapon in hand. When this monster king saw them, he laughed scornfully and gave a loud whistle. Immediately some 4,000 or 5,000 monster spirits, old and young, surged forward, all strong and sturdy, and they began a terrific battle on the west mountain slope. Marvelous fight. The vile, vicious demon mocks the true self. The true self's so gentle, what could it do? 100 plans used up, they can't escape their pain. 1,000 schemes cannot achieve their peace. The gods lend their protection. The sages help with their arms. Wood mother may still be kind, but yellow dame has made up its mind. Their brawl stirs heaven and shakes the earth. Their fight expands like a net spread out. On this side, banners wave and soldiers shout. On that side, they roll drums and beat gongs. A mass of swords and spears coldly gleaming. Thick rows of halberds veiled in dialthi pall. The fiendish troops are so fierce and brave. What could those divine fighters do? Wretched clouds hide both sun and moon. Grievous fog shroud mountains and streams. They strain and struggle in a bitter row. All for to Buddha Tang monk's faulty bow. Growing more fierce all the time, the monster spirit led his troops to charge again and again. Just at that moment when neither side proved to be the stronger, they heard the roar of pilgrim. Old monkeys arrived. Eight rules met him and asked, "Where's the luggage?" Old monkey almost lost his life already, answered pilgrim. "Don't mention any luggage." Gripping his precious staff, Sha monk said, "Stop talking now. We must go fight the monster spirit." The star spirits and those gods of darkness and light by now were encircled completely by the various fiends, and the old fiend wielded his club to attack the three of them. Pilgrim, Eight Rules, and Sha monk opened up their rod, staff, and rake to meet him head-on. They fought till truly the heaven grew dim and the earth darkened, but they could not prevail against the demon. They fought some more until the sun sank down in the west and the moon arose in the east. When the fiend saw that it was getting late, he signaled his subjects to be on guard by whistling loudly. Then he took out his treasure. When Pilgrim saw clearly that the fiend had untied his wrap and held it in his hand, he cried, "Look out! Let's run!" Without further regard for Eight Rules, Sha monk, and the other devas, he somersaulted all the way up to the ninefold heaven. The gods and his companions, however, were not quick enough to understand why he fled, and they were all captured once more inside the wrap after the monster spirit had thrown it in the air. Only Pilgrim thus managed to escape. After the monster king and his troops returned to the monastery, he asked for ropes again and ordered the prisoners to be tied up as before. The Tang monk, Eight Rules, and Sha monk were to be hung up high on the rafters, while the white horse was to be tied up in the back. After the deities had been trussed up, they were to be thrown into the cellar and the entrance would be covered and sealed. The little fiends obeyed each of his instructions, and we shall leave them for the moment. We tell you now about Pilgrim, who had leapt up to the ninefold heaven and succeeded in preserving his life. When he saw the withdrawal of the fiendish troops with banners lowered, he knew that his companions had been captured. Lowering his auspicious luminosity onto the eastern slope of the mountain, he hated, teeth grinding, the fiend. He thought of the monk shedding tears, lifting his face to stare skyward. He sighed sadly and voiced his fears. "Oh, master," he cried. "In which previous incarnation did you incur such ordeals of bondage that you must in this life face monster spirits every step of the way? It's so hard now to rid you of your sufferings. What shall we do?" He lamented like that all by himself for a long time, and then he began to calm himself and think, allowing the mind to question the mind. "I wonder what sort of rap this fiendish demon has," he thought to himself, "that can hold so many things. Now he has even hauled away all those celestial warriors. I would go seek the Jade Emperor for assistance, but I fear he might take offense. I recall, however, that there's a true warrior of the North, whose style is the demon-conquering celestial worthy, and who lives in the Wudong Mountain of the South Jambudvipa continent. Let me go fetch him here to rescue Master from this ordeal. Truly it is that. The immortal way undone, ape and horse disperse. Five phases dry up when mind and spirit are lost. We do not know what is the result of his journey. Let's listen to the explanation in the next chapter."